Welcome to this tutorial titled Why small l equal to 0 leads to capital L equal to 0 in quantum mechanics. In this session, we will explore an interesting and often misunderstood concept in quantum mechanics, the connection between the quantum number L and the angular momentum L. We will also address a common question: if angular momentum L is equal to 0, does that mean the electron is completely stationary? Let's begin this journey into the quantum world by revisiting some fundamental ideas and breaking down what angular momentum really means at the quantum scale. First, in quantum mechanics, angular momentum is not continuous, it is quantized. This means electrons can only occupy specific angular momentum states defined by discrete values, not just any arbitrary magnitude. Next, the orbital angular momentum quantum number, denoted by L, plays a central role here. It determines the magnitude of the angular momentum vector L. The relationship is given by the equation L equal h bar square root L into L plus 1. This is not just a mathematical curiosity, it reflects the inherent uncertainty and geometry in quantum mechanics. Now, what happens when small l equals 0? Plugging it into the formula, we see that capital L is equal to 0. But here's the important question. Does this mean the electron is not moving at all? Is it completely stationary? That's the puzzle we are going to unpack in the coming slides. Let's now focus more closely on the formula for orbital angular momentum. As shown here, the magnitude of angular momentum in quantum mechanics is given by L equal h bar square root L into L plus 1. This formula arises from solving the Schrodinger equation for central potentials like the hydrogen atom. Now let's consider the special case when the orbital quantum number L is 0. Plugging it into the formula, we get L equal h bar square root 0 and 0 plus 1 equal to 0. This clearly tells us the orbital angular momentum is 0. There is no angular momentum contribution from the electron's motion in this state. But here is the key point, and it often causes confusion. Does this mean the electron is stationary? Absolutely not. Zero angular momentum doesn't imply that the electron has stopped moving. It simply means there is no rotational or orbital angular momentum around the nucleus. The electron still has kinetic energy and dynamic behavior, but it doesn't carry angular momentum in the classical sense. This distinction is crucial and will be unpacked further in the next slides. Let's now address the core confusion: if L is equal to 0, does that mean the electron has no energy or motion? The answer is a resounding no. As shown in the first block, even with zero angular momentum, the electron still possesses kinetic energy. This is backed by the Virial theorem in quantum mechanics. Specifically for the hydrogen atom, it tells us that the average kinetic energy is minus half the average potential energy. So as long as there is potential energy, which there is due to the attractive force of the nucleus, there must be non-zero kinetic energy. In fact, the electron continues to move radially, meaning inward and outward from the nucleus, even if it is not orbiting in a circular or elliptical path. The next block brings in another critical concept, the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. It states that the variation in position and momentum must be greater or equal to h bar over 2. This states a hard limit in quantum systems. You can't simultaneously know an electron's exact position and momentum. So the idea of the electron having zero momentum, that is being completely stationary, violates this principle. Delta p equal to zero would imply delta x goes to infinity, which is unphysical. Finally, let's be absolutely clear, the electron is not stationary. L equal to 0 only means the electron has no net rotational motion, it is not orbiting with angular momentum. But it still has radial kinetic energy and its behavior is governed by quantum fluctuations. So even in the L equal to 0 state, the electron is very much active, just not in a classical orbit. Now let's refine our understanding by looking at the difference between radial and angular motion. The first block highlights a key idea where we say L equal to 0, it means there is no net orbital rotation. Mathematically, this is expressed as angular momentum vector sum, summation r cross p equals 0. That is, the average or total angular momentum due to the position and momentum vectors cancel out, there is no overall twist or swirl in the motion. Now this brings us to an important symmetry feature. The L equal to 0 state, known as the S orbital, is spherically symmetric. This means there are no angular nodes and the probability of finding the electron is the same in all directions around the nucleus. So while the electron still has dynamic motion, that motion does not favor any particular angular direction. The final block drives this point home. In an L equal to 0 state, any angular momentum that might arise statistically in one direction is cancelled by motion in the opposite direction. In quantum terms, average Lx and average Ly, they are equal to zero. That is, there is no average angular momentum along any axis. Instead, radial motion dominates. The electron moves toward and away from the nucleus but without any net spin around it. This is the subtle but powerful nature of motion in a quantum L equal to 0 state. So far, we have been discussing orbital angular momentum, which depends on the quantum number L, but electrons also possess a second type of angular momentum, spin. This is an intrinsic property of the electron denoted by the vector S. Its magnitude is also quantized, given by S equal h s into s plus 1 square root. Unlike orbital angular momentum, spin does not arise from the motion through space. It is a fundamental property, just like mass or electric charge. Every electron carries spin, no matter where it is or what it is doing. Now, how does this relate to total angular momentum? Spin angular momentum S and orbital angular momentum L are independent quantities. Together, they combine to form the total angular momentum given by G equal L plus S. This total angular momentum becomes particularly important when we consider interactions like spin-orbit coupling, which affects atomic energy levels and spectral lines. However, it is crucial to not confuse spin with classical motion. As noted in the final block, spin angular momentum does not involve any lateral rotation of the electron around an axis. There is no tiny spinning sphere or orbit. Spin has no classical analog. It is a purely quantum mechanical property deeply embedded in the mathematical framework of quantum theory. So even if L equals 0, the electron still has angular momentum, its spin. To ground our discussion in something concrete, let's look at the hydrogen atom's ground state. In this case, the quantum number are n equal to 1 and l equals 0. This corresponds to the 1s orbital, the lowest energy state available. The wave function for this state is psi 1s of r 1 over phi a naught cube e to the power minus r over a naught, where a naught is the Bohr radius. This expression describes how the probability amplitude changes with radial distance from the nucleus. It decays exponentially, which means the electron is most likely to be found close to the nucleus, and the probability decreases as we move farther out. In fact, the maximum probability density occurs right at the nucleus when r equals 0. Since this is an L equal to 0 state, it has no angular nodes, the electron cloud is spherically symmetric, and the probability only depends on how far you are from the nucleus, not in which direction. But here is a subtle point. Even though the probability density is spherically symmetric, we still have to account for the radial volume element when calculating probability in three dimensions. That is why we include 4 pi r square dr. This means the most probable radial distance is actually not zero. It is slightly away from the nucleus due to this volume factor. Finally, it is important to emphasize that this kind of motion is not classical. There is no fixed path or trajectory. The electron does not orbit in circles. Instead, it exists as a probability cloud fluctuating radially. So once again, zero angular momentum does not mean a stationary electron. The electron is moving in the quantum sense, not along a path, but through a probabilistic wave function. This is quantum motion, not classical mechanics. Let's now summarize the key points we have covered. First, when the orbital quantum number L equals 0, the corresponding orbital angular momentum is 0. That's a direct result of the quantization formula L equals h bar L into L plus 1 square root, which implies L equals 0. This means the electron carries no orbital angular momentum in this state. But, and this is absolutely crucial, they doesn't imply the electron is motionless. The electron remains in a non-stationary state, and we can confirm this through two fundamental ideas. The Virial theorem, which guarantees kinetic energy even in bound states, and the uncertainty principle, which forbids any quantum particle from having both perfectly known position and momentum. Together, these show that the electron continues to move predominantly through radial probability currents. Finally, let's make some key conceptual distinctions. The motion we are talking about here is radial and probabilistic, not classical, not rotational. And don't forget the role of spin. Even when L equal to 0, the electron still has spin angular momentum, s equal half. This spin exists independently of orbital motion and has no classical analogy. So in short, L equal to 0 means no orbital rotation, but the quantum world is never static. The electron is still dynamically active, just in a fundamentally non-classical way. To wrap up, here are a few key references that inform this presentation and provide deeper insight into the topics we have explored. Griffiths' Introduction to Quantum Mechanics, Shankar's Principles of Quantum Mechanics, and Quantum Physics by Eisberg and Resnick. These are excellent resources for building a solid foundation in quantum theory, especially for concepts like angular momentum, the hydrogen atom, and the wave function formalism. Thank you for joining me in this exploration. I hope this clarified one of the more subtle but important aspects of quantum mechanics. Until next time, keep questioning, keep exploring, and stay curious about the quantum world.